I will show you how to make this iPhone on off switch in Premiere Pro. So first, we need to go to the toolbar and then select the rectangle tool. Then head over to the screen and click and drag your mouse so you get this rectangle shape. Now make sure the shape layer is selected, then go to the Essential Graphics tab. If you don't have this window, then go to Window and then select Essential Graphics. Now simply increase the corner radius to the max value, which is 1000. And also make sure that you have a dark gray fill color. And to adjust the rectangle, we can select the selection tool and use these handles to adjust it. Now go to the timeline and click in this gray space to deselect everything. And then go to the toolbar again, and this time select the ellipse tool. And then go to the screen. And then hold shift while dragging to create a symmetrical circle. And then go to the essential graphics tab and change the fill color to white. And we should now see a white circle. Now use the selection tool to adjust the circle's position and move it to the left end of the shape like this. Now to animate the circle, we need to make sure that the circle layer is selected, and in effects and tools, move to the point where you want to start the animation. Then click on the stopwatch next to position to create a keyframe. Now move forward to the point where you want the animation to be complete. Then change the position values so the circle is on the other end. And we have now created this animation. And if you want to speed it up, then you can simply move the keyframes closer to each other. And if you want to smoothen out the effect, we can select both keyframes, then right click on one of them and then select temporal interpolation, ease in, and then do the same thing and select ease out. And this is how it looks now. And if you want even more control, then you can click on this arrow next to position to open the velocity settings. And then you need to have the keyframe selected in order to get these handles, and you can now create your own speed graph. Now we only need to change the color of the switch, so go to the effects panel and search tint, and then apply the effect to the bottom layer. Now before we make any changes, we first need to align the player with the keyframes. So select the top clip, and in effects and tools, move to the first keyframe using this arrow. Then select the bottom layer again, and in effects and tools, click on the stopwatch next to map white and map black 2 to create the keyframes. Now select the top layer again, and align the player to the last keyframe. And then select the bottom clip, and in effects and tools, next to map white 2, set the color to green, and set the map black 2 option to green as well. But you can also choose a different color if you like. And we have now created this effect. Subscribe!